Welcome to Lesson 1 of the free bookbinding e-course. Today, we'll be creating the bulk of your handmade book, the book sections. In bookbinding, these book sections are also known as book signatures. For this course, we'll be creating a book using 10 book signatures, and each signature will consist of 4 pieces of paper. Depending on the type of book that you wish to create, you can choose to use different types of paper. These papers can include colored papers, textured papers, reused magazine pages, etc. It's only limited by your creativity. In this course, we'll be using regular A4 sized paper that is commonly used for printing, and therefore these papers are easy to obtain. So just grab 40 pieces and let's get started. Do bear in mind that the thicker the paper you use, the more difficult it is to fold. Once you have your paper, let's start your book binding project by learning the most basic skill in bookbinding, known as scoring. First, align the short ends of the paper together. Make sure that they are aligned perfectly. And then fold each paper into half using a bone scorer as seen here. Essentially, you'll be pressing the paper down and forming a fold. This process will take some time, so go ahead and get started. Do take note that each piece of paper should be folded exactly into half. Repeat this for all 40 pieces of paper for your handmade book. Once you're done with the scoring, assemble your book signatures together. Remember, there should only be 4 pieces of paper in each book signature. Once you're done with the book signatures, let's move on to the next step, creating a template for the spine of your book. This template will be used to punch holes along each of your book signature later on, so make sure that the measurements you do here are more or less accurate. Grab a used or recycled paper that is of the same height of your book signatures. In this case, if you have a thicker paper, that will be better because you'll be using it as a template to punch holes later. Fold it into half lengthwise and score the paper as you did with the book signatures. Then open it up and fold it into half again, this time widthwise. And remember to score the paper. Open it up again, using the center marking, fold the paper into quarters widthwise and score each fold. Once you are done, you would have 3 folds along the length of the template, giving you 4 sections. Now we'll prepare some of the linen tape. The linen tape will be used along the spine of the book to give it some strength. We'll be using the linen tape to measure the distance of the holes along your book spine. So prepare 3 stripes of linen tape. Each tape should be longer than the thickness of your final handmade book. You can either measure out the linen tape by stacking all 10 book signatures, or simply use a longer length of linen tape like we did here. Using each of the folds you have made along the length of the template as a point of reference, We'll be using the width of the linen tape to mark out the holes. Place your linen tape in the middle of a fold and mark out the ends of the linen tape. Repeat this for all three folds and you will get 6 markings along your template. For the extreme ends, add an extra marking between the end of the template and the very first mark that you see. In total, you should have 8 markings along your template. Do refer to your PDF guide for detailed instructions. Now that you have marked out where the holes should be, use your compass tool to poke holes along the template following the markings. These holes will be where your handmade book will be bound at. Binding will be covered in the next lesson. In the meantime, it's time to punch holes along the spine of each of your book signature. In our project, we use an old textbook as a base when we punch holes. Alternatively, you can also do this on any flat surfaces or on a cardboard. This will protect your desk from any damages. Before you start, mark the top of your template to ensure that all the book signatures are prepared the same way. Then align your template along the fold of your book signature. And punch holes using the compass tool at the mark regions. Repeat this for all 10 book signatures that you have. Once you're done, you can stack your book signatures up and align the holes. And we are done for today's lesson. Remember to keep your book signatures in a safe place. We'll be using it tomorrow. Stay tuned for lesson 2 that's coming tomorrow. We'll be doing the actual book binding. See you!